Hi folks, Will from MinIO here. In this video, we're going to take a look at Python. Now, the MinIO Python SDK does require Python 3.7. Some of the supporting libraries, most notably the URL lib, which has the certify lib as part of it, not supported in 2x anymore. You have to have 3.7. But it's fully integrated with pip, so I just do a pip 3 install MinIO, and boom, I have the whole MinIO library available at my fingertips. It's really great. The nice thing about the MinIO library is that it is largely method-driven, which means I only have to do one real class import, and then I can do everything. The documentation there takes you out to our SDK for Python, gives you all the details you need to know. But at the top of my code, I would just do that from MinIO, import MinIO, done. Now I can do all my MinIO work in my Python code. The key object to all of this is the MinIO client object. And the way that you build this is with a very simple constructor. The constructor takes various arguments like the endpoint and the keys that you need to actually connect, but it's very simple to use. And once I have that client, that's where I run all my methods from. It's the same constructor, whether I'm talking about local or I'm talking about a remote host, it's all very easy to do. The nice thing about this is that I write my code in a certain way, I could actually put all of the details here that you're seeing in my code example, I could put all those details into a config file and just read them, right? Which means that changing from a development environment to a production environment, trivial. I just change which config file I'm working with. I don't even have to change any code. A local deployment generally just needs the endpoint, the user, and the password. You may need to have a region if you're working in the cloud. By the way, that play.min.io, that's legal. That's actually the access key and the secret key. You can also do session tokens. You can also do credentials. All that other good stuff is also supported as well. So it's really a very easy way to build this client. By default, all connections are going to use TLS, period. If you want to use something that is not TLS, if you're doing a development environment, you don't have the certificates or all that other stuff, by all means, you can do a secure false. Don't do it in production. Do not do this in production, but you can definitely do a secure false if you're just testing out something. Okay, it's the last thing you want to add. It's in more than one way, it's the last thing you want to add. All right, we have inside of this Python SDK though, now that we've got our client set up, what can we do with it? Well, we've got a very robust set of tooling to examine objects in buckets. The entire API is listed right there, but some examples, you can list buckets, you can list objects across the entire server. You can work with versioning. You can turn versioning on, you can turn it off. You can see different versions of different objects. You can work with bucket replication. You can see what's been replicated. You can see where in the bucket lifecycle things are. You can turn on lifecycle management. You can turn off lifecycle management. You can set and remove locks and legal holds. All the things that you've seen in other videos in this series, you can do largely through the MinIO Python SDK. So it's really great. Let's take a look at some simple tasks. Those of you who are just getting started with this, I don't want to flood you with everything, but you can list your bucket contents. The list objects method gives you a list of objects, and you can just come back and print every single object as it comes back. You can do versions. You can do recursive if you have a prefix tree that you want to traverse, and you can also filter by a specific prefix if you want to. But the cool thing about this is you can then get a list of all the objects. So if you have a bucket that had an event on it, I can then go back and say, okay, I see that I had this bucket event. What objects are in that bucket? Another piece of information you could get is this list buckets. This is going to give you all the different buckets that you have out there. All you need to do is tell the client that you want to list the buckets. This doesn't even really require anything coming in from the event. Maybe at the beginning of your event, you just want to do a list of all the buckets. Maybe that's part of your handling of an event. You want to see any buckets that may have been changed. Maybe you sort by creation date or something like that, okay? So there's lots of different ways you can handle this. Stat object is a really excellent tool. It allows you to see all of the different details about an object. Now, why is this important? Some of the details about an object, if I'm watching for puts, some of the details about an object will be part of the actual event that gets handed to me, but not all of them. For instance, last modified is a feature of the object that is not going to be included in the event. Now you can kind of say to myself, okay, well, now it was last modified, blah. But if I want to know exactly when MinIO says it was last modified, I can get that information with the stat object. There's lots of different pieces to stat object that you can use to get a lot more detail about an object. So if somebody uploaded an object and it was a new version of an object or something along those lines. Maybe I want to check the number of versions I have. So maybe I want to get that version ID. Maybe I want to get that specific thing. Maybe I want to get some tags. Maybe I want to see the E tag. Maybe there's some different things that I want to see that are not included in the event. Stat object is a good way to go. I hope you've enjoyed this video series on event handling. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen, or you can chat with us interactively on slack.min.io. Also, you can just leave a message here on one of our videos and we will get back to you. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.